Hey, quick question.
There you go.
It's just a question. Seriously, I want to know, like, why is it? Why is it that I can say the word nigger with impunity? But I can't say the word faggot.
It's a good fucking question.
And she said, because, David, you are not gay. I said, well, Renee, I'm not a nigger either. I was leaving it occurred to me.
Dave gets it because Dave has been putting up with this shit forever. But there's not, like, what is it? What is it? They're just fucking words. They have no power. They have nothing other than what you give them. And yet people are so afraid of these things. They're so terrified that you might say this thing. But are they? No, of course they're not actually scared. They're never scared. Keffals is not scared that I said that Keffals belongs on the fucking wall with the pedophiles and the groomers. That doesn't harm Keffals. It probably gave Keffals an extra 10,000 grift bucks on their fucking GoFundMe or whatever. Right? Like these people are professional victims. Being victimized is a good, it's a moral good for them. They will fall on the swords, and that's not a euphemism for them falling on gay penises. They will fall on the sword forever because their victim status is their currency. They can turn that currency into money. They can turn it into power. Most importantly, they can turn that victimhood into control of you and me. That's what they can do with it. They're not scared of anybody. Why would they be? They're the most protected people on the planet. If you breathe wrong on a fucking weirdo like Keffals, you will be condemned. You will be given, you'll be charged with a hate crime. You will go directly to prison. You will not get bail. You won't get anything. They will immediately do this, and they'll go and also rape your children, and they'll like it because that's what these people do. That's what they want. They're not scared. They want to turn their victimhood into your fear. Because this is how they will control the new church. And the new church is this. It is not only free from criticism of protected classes. It is a requirement that you venerate protected classes. You must put the girl penis in your mouth and then in your ass. And if you don't, you're a fucking bigot. If you do not accept the forced sex of the T-girl, then you are the bigot. They will force you into veneration. They will force you to your knees. They will demand not only that you say the words, but that you believe them and you like them. They will fucking put you down. They will threaten your wife, your husband, your kids, your nieces, your nephews, your grandkids, your dogs, your cats, your job, your hobbies. They will take and take and take until you not only say, please give me your tranny fag penis. And then they will whip it out. And you better fucking slobber all over it. If you don't do that, then they will take everything they can take. but it's not. It starts with the speakers, the people who tell jokes, the people who tell the truth. It starts there. But it ends with everyone. It ends with the average person who has no dog in this hunt, right? They have no dog in this hunt. They have no dick in this cunt. They have nothing in the fight. They will grab them and they will demand compliance with acceptable speech. They will require the words to be said. That's the truth. And it will be everyone. This is no longer a censorship game. This is the tyranny of the deranged, the tyranny of the mentally ill. And by the way, hashtag not all trans people, obviously. People like Iron Liz, people like Crumbrion who have been on the show, very trans people. Notice what they're not trying to do? Not trying to force you to do or say anything about them, about their status. They don't fucking care. Just like everybody else. Do you walk around demanding people recognize your heteroness? And if they don't, you shove your balls in their ass? Of course not. Well, I mean, maybe. But this is the new tyranny, the new censorship. It's not about stopping any speech anymore at all. It's about forcing a lexicon on you that you don't want. Like, we're over here, me included, we're all in the fucking past. We're all here like, can I please just say faggot? Like, I don't actually care about gays. I just want to call people faggots because it's funny. And it doesn't have anything to do with being gay. It just means you're being a faggot. Like, that's us. That's all we're doing. We're just like, can I just say this word? Like, because I think it's funny. Like, can I just do that? That's where we are. We're way in the fucking past. They're not worried about that anymore. Right now, they're worried about forcing everyone into the new lexicon. Every single person must accept the newspeak. It's not about getting rid of the few people who are willing to tell jokes, the few people who can be edgy, the few people who are willing to use an offensive word here and there. Those people are dying. They're being removed. They're literally dying. They're retiring. They're going away. They're just hiding forever. Like, not hiding. They're hidden from public view enough already. They're shadow banned from everywhere. You know what I'm saying? It's about taking all the people who would never say faggot in their entire life and forcing them to affirm gay marriage, to affirm kid drag shows, to affirm gender transitions for 8-year-olds, to affirm everything. And if they, to affirm fucking pedophilia. That's what they're doing now. They're going to force it through language until it is no longer shocking. Because, well, everybody thinks pedophiles are fine, and then it will be. That's the new church. The new church will degeneracy into order or into existence. It will it, and then it will force it. It will force it down throats, and then it will force it back out. If you're in Canada, you already know this, right? You know that it's not a matter of censoring Canadians. What Canadian have you ever heard of that needs to be censored? What Canadian, like, you've ever run into a Canadian, they're like, well, let me just tell you about banking. Like, oh, shit. No. Like, Canadians are just rather jovial weirdos in the north. you don't need to censor them. It's not about censoring the Canadians. It's about forcing and compelling the Canadians to speak in a certain way. This is what Jordan Peterson was against. This is what Jordan Peterson had the problem with. Compelling people to speak. You must say their new name. How dare you dead name them? Lucas, your name isn't dead. It's alive. Lucas. 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 God, I feel like I'm sprinkling holy water every time I say it.